And here we are, the Elder Scrolls 3 Morrowind. I've played this game so many times as a kid, but I could never actually take it seriously. It was a game I would just boot up on my first Xbox and just start goofing around and just, you know, doing kid stuff in the game. But I never actually took it seriously, the storyline and whatnot. So the beginning area of the game, once you get off the boat and you go to Balmora and meet Caius, that is pretty much what I know, like the back of my hand, the little secrets, things like that. But anything after that is just new to me. So throughout this Let's Play, you're gonna start seeing me asking questions and getting lost and stuff like that. So for the first episode, I'll leave that in. I'm just going to be doing things as I normally would in the point of view of someone that's never played the game. But in the second episode, I'll probably be starting to chop out things that, you know, just me walking around aimlessly looking for special plays. So depending how it goes on the first episode, how you guys like it, just let me know what do you think. If I should just leave in me walking around and things like that, or I should just cut that and stick to the meaty bits. Alright, so here we go.
From the Imperial City's prison. First by carriage and now by boat. To the east, to Morrowind. Fear not, for I am watchful. You have been chosen.
Wake up. We're here. Why are you shaking? Are you okay? Wake up.
And that is so nostalgic. Anytime now.
Stand up.
There you go.
You were dreaming.
That was weird.
What's your name?
Let's see. My name is Armando. Hello, Jude.
Well, not even last night's storm could wake you. I heard them say we reached Morrowind. I'm sure they'll let us go. Quiet. Here comes the guard.
This is where you get off. Come with me.
And MGSO looks
you
great.
Do what they say.
I'm not going to lie. Look at the trapdoor and press spacebar to open it. Spacebar activates objects and people. Alright, Seda Neen, holy hell, look at this. Man, I guess that's great.
This is where they want you. Head down to the dock and I'll show you to the census office.
Alright, Mr. Guard, let's go.
You finally arrived. Our records don't show from where.
Alright. Usually back in the day, I always played Dark Elf. So that's who I am going to stick as. Not bad. Not too fond of the face. Alright, he has a weathered look. I like that. Someone that has experience. Let's do it. Let's see the hair though. I usually play a lot of magic, so I'll probably stick to someone that knows.
Great. I'm sure you'll fit right in. Follow me up to the office and they'll
someone that looks like they know magic. Excuse me. Oh yes, here comes. Yes. We were expecting you. Here it comes.
Yes, we've been expecting you. You'll have to be recorded before you're officially released. There are a few ways we can do this, and the choice is yours.
I'll pick from a class list. Makes it pretty quick, and I know more or less. Alteration, destruction, conjuration, axe, and heavy armor. Not so much keen on the axe. Let's keep going. Mysticism, long blade, marksman, enchant, and alchemy. What about a normal mage? Mysticism, destruction, alteration, illusion, and restoration. All the major magic fields are there. Enchant, alchemy, unarmored, short blade. Alright.
Very good.
What I'm going
to
pick.
The letter that preceded, you mentioned you were born under a certain sign. And
now,
what would that be?
And that would be the mage. Fortify magic, 0.5 intelligence, I think, INT.
Interesting. Now, before I stamp these papers, make sure this information is correct.
Okie dokie. Yeah, everything seems pretty good.
Show your papers to the captain when you exit to get your release fee.
Alrighty, this is the only little glitch, I would say, that I'm probably going to do. Well, most of you watching already know what it is, so might as well.
You stole it! Cowardly thief!
Alright. Mohahaha.
Continue through to the next building and talk to Celis Gravis.
And now we steal everything. Yes. Hiriscar, I don't think I've forgotten our wager. I want this dagger sharp as a scamp's claw by morning. Gonciel. Alrighty. Give me all the bread. Can't take that. I can probably sell those. Firmament. I always take this book. It's just a habit. I know I shouldn't, but it's not worth much. Did this grab me? Yep. Silverware. Flynn. Silverware picture cup. Not worth that much. And this is a lockpick. I always used to leave the lockpick thinking it's a knife. And never actually, you know, highlighted it. See what it is. It's just a little bedroll, things like that. I think these are just ingredients. Yes, they are. Since I am probably going to be doing a good amount of alchemy, I'll just be taking what I can. Oh man, that animation. It's a little slows me down a bit. Hey, what am I talking about? I'm not that even a fast of a player. Fark off spring. And that is all. I got my name. Yep. Sir. Background. I am Sylvanas Gravius. Knight errant of the Imperial Legion. Tell me a little bit about Morrowind. Yes, you are a Morrowind. I don't know why you're here, why you release, yada yada yada. Okie dokie. Duties. This packet came in with news of your arrival. You have taken to Caius Casadas in the town of Balmora. Oh man, Balmora is gonna kill my graphics card. I'm not really sure why, but MGSO destroys my graphics card. It's I'm running a Strix 1080. Yeah, for some reason it just kills it. I have an i7, a 6700, unlockable. I'm at 4.7 at 1.35 volts, or 1.37, one of the two. And this game is very, very taxing. Alright, got the package, and let's head on out. Let's get to review. If you ever want to read what it says on the screen, I'll leave it up for a couple seconds each little page, and you can just pause and take a look at what it is. Alright, you're on your own now, so good luck. I like that little tip it just tells you. Go to Ariel's trade house. Now before we go to Ariel's, let's take a little gander over here. Man, it looks great. Let's see if I remember. I sure as hell. Supposed to get inside that old tree stump. What in the hell? MGSO has some great sounds, man. Sorry if I sound a little, you know, bored or anything. I promise you it's not that. This game is amazing. I'm just getting down over a cold. And it feels kind of poopy. Oh, hello. The Iron Short Axe. This is very, very good to start off. It's a little bit something, but better than nothing. Where is the other tree stump? It should be around here. No, it's. I think this is the second one. Where is the first one? Oh, here it is. Well, the new foliage. Can't really see it much. Alright, now we're off to see Hrisgar. I'm not sure if just staying up the lighthouse, Fargoth automatically activates and he goes to the hollow tree stump over there, but I'm just gonna go over here and make sure. And the developers of this mod really did a great job. Textures and everything, they're perfect. Here it is. Recover some gold. Sure. Alrighty, let's get going.
Speak quickly.
By the way, guys, if you guys have any tips, if I should lower my microphone and up the game's volume, or, you know, vice versa, you're more than welcome to, you know, leave a comment, let me know. I'm new at it, at doing Let's Plays and things like that. This is something I'm just doing because I'm bored, you know, getting over a cold, have nothing else better to do. Oh man, it is dark in here. It looks great. The candles, the music, it's very nostalgic. Alright, let's get going. This book is worth a lot. Your unarmored skill increased to 21. Good, because I should be using robes and light armor. Give some grief. And also, let me know if you like short videos, longer videos, edited videos, or just a simple, straight up, long the line Let's Play like how I'm doing now. Alright, so it is 12 p.m. Let's wait a good, I would say 8 hours. Nah, kick it to 9. And it is dark, holy hell. I never actually talked to Forgoth when I got out of the boat. Out of the office. The census office. I wonder if that's going to mess up anything. Oh no, wait, he's crouching. He's doing the thing. There he goes. Ah, so by the way, sorry about the room. It's quite a mess right now. Sorry about that. I really have to get a microphone boom because I'm using a desktop blue, I think it's called a Snowball Ice microphone. It's pretty good. It's decent. I have a Audio Technica, really great microphone, but I had an M-Box Mini audio interface, and that's what I used to use for music and all that. Oh, here we go. Acrobatic skill. It went up. Okay. So like I was saying, I had an M-Box Mini. It's an audio interface. When it worked, it was pretty decent, and then all of a sudden, it just died. I plug it into the computer, it lights up, the computer does not detect it. I tested it out with a Mac. Same thing, it lights up, the Mac does not detect it. So unfortunately, I think it is fried. If anyone, by any miracle, if anyone is watching that they know about M-boxes and have had that problem before, just please let me know. Because before I go out and buy a new one so I can use my original mic, I want to see if I can save that, the M-Box. Okay, so I have the money. I have 413 septums. I have no robes, no nothing. I'm just a poor man. You know what the hell. Let's see. Carol. Do you have any magical... No, he does not. Yeah, he's pretty bare bones starter. All right. I think I do have light armor. I'll take some of those. Definitely be taking a common robe. It's better than nothing. I could do without the robe. I'll get a shirt and I'll be enchanting that. This light stuff. You know, I'll be taking the robe, yes it is. It's not that much. Alright, so I have the Nordic boots and the Nordic chest plate. Well, the cuirass. Okie dokie, let's see. Chitin, left and right gauntlet. Yeah, that's right. I don't think he has light greaves, doesn't he? Just iron. Huh, it's better than nothing. One thing I like about Morrowind more than obviously Oblivion and Skyrim, you know, both those are amazing games. Excuse me. But in those games, armor is just, you know, chest armor comes with left and right shoulders and, you know, things like that. I may be wrong, I haven't played them in a while, but I just. One thing I like about Morrowind is the amount of customization you can do. It's not so much. I've never been such a, you know, like, quote unquote, hardcore player and getting so into the game. I just like having, you know, bone mode here, cheating there, you know, having a little bit of difference, or just having just one overpowered, you know, shoulder armor, a robe, a certain helmet, you know, things like that. It's what makes the game more in-depth. Alright, so let's quit wasting time, see if he takes it. Yes, he does. I am out of here.
My patience is limited.
Okay. Alright, we're at 23 minutes now. I am going to wait till the daytime, and we're gonna walk to Balmora. 10 hours. Alright, what time is it now? 9 a.m. Perfect. Alright, so.
Hurry this up, will you?
Listen, boy. Yeesh. I'm not even gonna talk to him. Alright, now that I'm here. Whoopty. That goes away. That goes away. I need those pants, unfortunately. Oh, I forgot to get a helmet. It's not like I'm going to be doing that much, but whatever. And the only item I have for now is that. Oh crap, I forgot to sell my limeware platter. I'll sell that once I get to Balmora. Okay, so. Oh, very important. I am eating a bologna here. There it is. I think, if I recall correctly, there's a quest for the Mage's Guild, where you have to go and search for mushrooms. And I think before doing that, you can actually find all those mushrooms on your way to Balmora. So, I'm just gonna take a quick little look. before going over there. And by the way, I'm playing this game with no big mods besides you know, these graphical improvements. It's MGSO, I think it's MGSO 3, the latest one. But there's no game altering mods. Just the basic ones that it came with. The NGS on me. Okay, last I remember that place was bad memories. I got my ass handed to me. Next time I come back to Satan, you know, drop in. I just really want to get to Balmora. I want to see how it looks like. Especially with the mod. I should be expecting something. I think it's this way. Yeah, I think Evan Hart. Oh no, Balmora's this way. Where is he? Just pop in. Oh shit. Yeah, you can tell. Whoa, I hit my mouse. And you are dead. I don't think the gods like that. Now that I am here, very smart. Hold on, let me just quickly check if I have a quick save button. F5, alright. There we go. If I remember, there is a guy that falls from the sky, and, well, you know what I mean. So, what do you train him? Okay. Sorry for asking. Hey, a scrib! I seen you guys since about 2002, 2003. I think I might have taken a wrong turn. This is... I'm a bit clumsy. I get just too distracted in game and, you know. This is why I was saying if you guys want me to just cut everything out or, you know, just leave it in, make it a little bit more original, make it more me, and not just straight to the point. Like I said, it's up to you guys, it's whatever you guys like. I'm not all that great at editing videos and all that, so it would be a straight up just chop up and it'd be nasty. There we go. Where's my map? Yeah, Balmora, it's this way. There we go. Alright, for that quest, I know I'm supposed to be picking up some kind of, I can't reach that. Some kind of fungus that, two of them grow off trees. That I do remember. Ingredients. Since I don't really weigh much, I mean, might as well. Now that I'm here. By the way, I never actually introduced myself formally. My name is Armando Latour. I am a very, very boring person from Miami. Oh, okay. So there we go. I believe I am in the right track. There's a bar over there. So yeah, I live in Miami. So it's pretty decent around here. It's not really my preferred, you know, living style. It's very, you have to be very outgoing and things like that to really, really enjoy Miami. Never been too big in, you know, parties and whatnot. You know, I'm the only child. Well, when I was young, I've always liked to, you know, just stay in my room playing Super Nintendo, and then when the N64 came out, it was just it was tough for me to even think about leaving my room. But once I was about 10, 11 years old, in the year 2000, 2001, I was born in 1990, so in the year 2000, before 9/11, me and a couple of friends, for Christmas we got, I think it was GoPeds, and since then on, that's when I started going out a little bit more and things like that, and actually enjoying, you know, being outside. But even now, it's I go to work, I hang out with a couple of buddies, things like that. I hear a rat. Where is it? Well, just for now, I'm just trying to get to Balmoral. Ignoring all the side quests, because I think that has to do with a Nord that is naked somewhere, if I recall correctly. Also, what do you guys think about the Elder Scrolls Online, the new Morrowind part, the add-on? Well, not add-on, the expansion is coming out in June. It looks pretty good. I was watching gameplay footage of it, of a few of the developers, and it looks great, let me tell you. I'm stocking up. It's not bad. Seeing those reminds me of the cliff racers. Is that one over there? No. Back in 2002, 2003, when I had Morrowind on the first Xbox, that was great. A friend of mine, he was really, really into it. He completely burned out the game, and like, so many hours spent on it. And watching him play, like, it pretty much made me fascinated with the game, the atmosphere, everything about it. Look at this. Obviously, you know, this looks nothing like the original Morrowind, even less on Xbox. Yeah, you know, the bad draw distance and horrible frame rates. But it was great. Good times. Good old times. But the game that I really got into was Oblivion. Out of Morrowind, Oblivion, and Skyrim, I would say Oblivion was the one that I put the most amount of time into. Like, all the expansions, Shira Gorath, it was just insane. And I don't know if you guys have noticed, but I'm not the greatest talker. Usually if I have like a friend over, things like that, it'll be a little bit more entertaining, because I've never really been much of a talker. Even less, you know, talking on my own like this, it's kind of awkward. Like, I don't know, I see other people on YouTube, and man, they can carry out a conversation on, like, by themselves. Like, I know obviously I'm doing it, but it's a little bit more forced than it, than anything. Dude, that looks nasty. It blends in nicely over here, but over there, eh. I mean, what more can I ask for? Again, looks beautiful. It's funny how here it just starts getting a little bit more dark. The colors a little bit more muted. You go that way, you know, before that, everything was like lush and green and mushroomy. Now it looks a little bit more cold. The fog is setting in. Oh man. It just looks beautiful. Sorry, I'm just, you know, taking it in. The sound effects that the mod adds is, oh wow. Oh, they even add a little guy fishing. That is great. And so many hours I've put into this. Remember, I think there is an ancestral tomb over there that I have to go into. I think it's that way, or on the other side of Balmora. Either way, it's the Silk Striders. That's I'm impressed.
The prey approaches.
The prey? Boy, you a slave. What the hell are you talking about, a prey? No. I think, are the guys still up there? Or did they relocate them? Ah, they're still up there. What is this? The Council Club. And I think the Thieves Guild was over here. I think it was this one. I think it's called the Corner Club, if I'm not mistaken. My friend... Not this one. It should be one of these. I think it's this one. There we go. Has a sign. Yep, the Corner Club. That should be it. But, let's get going to Caius's house.
Speak, traveler.
Yeah, it's pretty taxing on the graphics card. Even though I have my 1080 overclocked and everything, but man, oh man, it is. It gets pretty bad. Obviously, you know, the game is not optimized to be running on, you know, Windows 10 and today's graphics cards. Mr. Cox, you look quite different. I was told to come to you, sir. Yes, my name is Monday. I'm told to report to me and deliver a package. Perhaps you let me look at it? Sure thing. Here is my package. Sure thing, let me trust a complete stranger. Welcome to service. No, this Officer Mondo. Member of the Imperial Blades. We watch the Emperor's enemies, look for opportunities, and we make reports. And when the Emperor commands, we obey. Hey, your personal stuff, like that fat skooma pipe. Like I said, the beginning of the game, I know pretty okay, you know, just a normal person that plays the game. But beyond this, I know you go to the Fighters Guild and you have to take care of rats and someone's cellar. I remember there was a bunch of pillows there. And I know if you go to the Mage's Guild, you have to go get a puzzle box from a dwarven ruin. And then after that comes the mushrooms. I always did the Mage's Guild first few quests, and then, you know, I would give up on that and just start messing around. I would just go exploring the game, walk into the wrong cave, and then I would forget that my save was about 2 or 3 hours before death. And, well, you know, anger comes after that. Okay. Make your stones. Alright, so I do know that once I go to Kaya's, he just tells me, you know, you can go do freelance work and, you know, just try to pretty much level up a little bit before taking his next mission. He's with the main storyline of the game. What was that? Okay, like I was saying, and there it is. The good school of vibe. Alright, so Caius is with the, he's the beginning of the main quest of the game. And the Fighters Guild, and, you know, everything else is pretty much just optional side quests. Of course, you have to level up a little bit to do his main quest. But after that, to me, it is just, I don't know. And I think it is raining outside, is it? That is pretty cool. That's nice. Let's sleep for about, I would say, 14 hours. Like that.
You want something, friend?
Oh, good lord, man. Ow. Kaius, I think I'm part of the blades. You're supposed to help. My lord. Whew. I have forgotten to save for a while. Good thing they don't come after you. I'm not sure, but I think that's a tad bit early in the game for these guys to be after you. Come on. Oh, out of cues. Let's see. I don't even have much magicka left. Not me either way, I'll talk to him. I'll be back. I'm pretty sure he'll still be in there. Look at that, I'm at 37 frames per second. Yeesh. I'll look that way. 42, 40, 47. That's not too. It's alright. Usually on Battlefield 1 and all that, you know, games that are made for DirectX and all that. The Guild of Mages! I am finally here. Man, it's 45 minutes and continuing. Ajira.
What is this about?
Okay. Since I am now part of the Mage's Guild, I should have access to the supply chest. fortifying. Willpower, yes. Ordinary magical potions. Interventions. I'm not sure what intervention actually does. I don't think I have a soul trap. Yeah, what's that book? Worth pretty good money though. Alright, let's go see where is Akira. And I think I'm going to end it soon. I am running at 46 minutes and I am getting pretty tired. Been a long day for me. You are the orc. I remember that.
Speak quickly.
Oh yes, you are the orc.
What assistance do you need?
Yes, there he is.
Why do you approach?
I approach. Yes, dear lord, I know you're gonna tell me to go fuck off into God knows where to look for damn mushrooms because we're on a trip. Do I have him? Huh. See, that's what I was talking about. You start picking off like little mushrooms and ingredients for alchemy here and there, and maybe you'll pick up what she needs, and boom. There you go. Alright, so what are the next two things? Take these mushrooms and ready to board once you give fake some time. Alright, Galbadir, I will be doing this.
I suppose it is my duty to help those less fortunate than myself.
No. You're Shar, whatever the orc. Also, if you guys like a little bit of role playing, like I said, just let me know anything that I can do to improve. No, I'm not gonna steal, but I will be placing in this. Boop. Okay, so I'm supposed to leave that one there. Okay, that is pretty cool. The closer you get to the door, well, you know, any doors, the more you hear it, you move away from it, and there goes. Okay. Yes, I have. Good lord. Oh man. Do I have him? Oh! Yes! Sweet. Yeah, that's why I pick up everything, like I said. Any other. I just knocked down three quests just that quickly. This I have to go buy at the market. Alright, 10 minutes and I am done. There's a ceramic bowl, right? And that's for and cats and bowls and milk and... Alright, where is the little market that was over here? It's a little guy's house, I remember. Ah, Javier! Yes. I know for a fact that you have some pretty interesting things. I'm not sure if redware or ceramic. Oh, ceramic bowl. There it is. Now that I'm here, let me see if I can get rid of some stuff. Ah, man, this chair is a little bit uncomfortable. Am I good here? Yes, I am. Alright. Oh, it's good here. Ooh, already at 460. Alright, now tell me, what do you have? Oh, a bound dagger. I think you have a metal thing. I've never really been too big on the bound weapons. But I don't think I have much of a choice for now. Is there a helmet? I need one. The neck armor is it's pretty decent. Actually, I have absolutely no clue, to be honest with you. Like I said, I'm playing this pretty blind. Which is, I would say, the beginning of, like, you know, such a great game like that. The first time that you really play it, it's pretty magical. You know, that sounds kind of corny, but as close as I can get to actually describing it. You know, you can get so attached to a game and play it over and over and over again, you know, like I have with so many other games. But there's nothing like that very, very first time that you just, you know, you get hooked. Everything feels fresh and brand new. Leather gauntlet, and I have chitin, I don't know how to pronounce it. It's not much here that I can, you know, go crazy for. I know later on he has some great stuff, but look at this. I like that demon tonsil. That I'm gonna go for that, and I'll get rid of this stuff. This is cannon fodder, but something. But I'm actually shocked I managed to pick up every correct plant and mushroom. It feels good, it feels great. The firmament, get rid of that for now. Iron dagger. Is this a short blade? Yes, it is a short blade, so cool. Will you do 390? Yes, you will.
Kajit has no time for you.
Oh, piss.
What
on.
Say you?
What am I carrying now? 690, that's not too bad. It's not that bad. Not that bad. Okay, Ajita, let's see. Wait, what am I doing? Oh, hello. I forgot you are an alchemist. I really need to be buying a alembic or mortar and pestle. Oh, Lord! 2400 for that? What is this, a master's? Yes, it is. Do you have a journeyman's mortar and pestle? No, you don't. Ugh. Ah, oh, come on, man. I just got you all this shit.
Find a healer.
Oh, that's right, yeah.
It's
the... What? Oh. Yeah, about that. Stolen reports, what? Gobbledy restored your reports on the progress to look mushrooms. Oh, dear lord. Gabby did not leave the mage guild, so the reports must be nearby. Okay. No thank you for now, at least. I'll do that next time. Where is it? The ceramic bowl. Yes, here it is. Let's go to the ceramic. Okay, I am done for now. On the next episode, we're going to be looking for those reports that their party, you know, somewhere in here. It's not that big of a place. But if you like what I'm doing, just, you know what to do. Thumbs up. If you don't like it, I am open for feedback and, you know, just let me know how you think I can do better. Alright, so I'll see you next time.